Good day, everyone. Jewel here with J7409 Weather, Monday, August the 10th, 2020. How is everybody? I hope everybody is safe and sound this morning. A lot of you have asked me, did I feel the earthquake yesterday? No, I did not. No, I did not. The earthquake that was felt yesterday occurred up around Selma. It was felt in Virginia, all the way down to Atlanta, Georgia. How about that? This morning, we still have at least 200,000 people that are still in the dark without power in the northeast section of the U.S., all from Isis. Now, we've got 20 million people that have a heat alert advisory today. In eastern North Carolina, it's going to be another hot one too, with a heat index of 100. Now, as we look at the watches and warnings map, let's start over here, where you see Oregon, Washington State, Nevada, Idaho. Over here in Nevada, parts of California, all of these areas, a little bit of Utah down here. You guys are under a fire watch this morning. You're going to have hot temperatures. You're going to have the humidity levels just right. If any fires break out, they're going to spread very rapidly. Please don't do any burning in these areas. We do have a fire watch advisory, red flag warning over in, as you can see, right in this area of Wyoming this morning. And then as we move down, this is a smog alert, bad weather, so far as breathing conditions going on with the air in western Colorado. Then we come down to Arizona, where it is bright, bright, dark red with a little bit of pink in there. Folks, my goodness gracious, it is going to be, you're under a heat warning for today, of course, a heat warning. Your heat index could get up to 116 degrees. Now, Boston, up here where you see this orange, Boston, Connecticut, parts of New York, you're under a heat advisory. It's going to feel like 96 or above today for you guys. And then when we move down around Tennessee, Illinois, Arkansas, Oklahoma, North and northwestern Mississippi, all of these areas right in here. Well, it's going to be a cooker, folks. You can expect a heat index anywhere from 105 to 109 degrees. You are under a heat advisory. Heat advisory. So it's going to be a hot one. These are the watches and warnings, what they're looking like right now. Please drink plenty of fluids. Stay cool as you can if you're in any of these areas. It is this time of the year. It is August. We got some hot, hot weather still to go through. So please stay safe. Now, as we look at the categorical outlook for severe weather today, it's looking like scattered to some strong severe thunderstorms. They're going to be possible. It's summertime again later today from Kansas to Illinois. Now, it's looking like the most severe thing out of these thunderstorms at this time will be the wind. It's looking like severe gust is going to be the primary hazard. That could change as the evening goes on, but right now it's looking like this. Don't forget, anywhere, in whether it's light green, marginal dark green, or bumped up to a level 2 in the yellow, anywhere in the green, we could have a pop-up thundershower today, so be aware of it. When it comes to tornadoes, less than 2%. One might pop up, but the chances are not great at all. It's looking like these storms are just going to be very bad rain and wind makers. When we look at the wind, it goes all the way down from a little bit of New Mexico all the way up to Michigan. You can see where it's 5% chance of maybe some very gusty winds, but if you are in Kansas, Arkansas, and this portion of Illinois, it's going to be bumped up, so do not be surprised at some very high wind gusts coming your way. The hail outlook is in the very same area at 5%. I want to say thanks for all my new subscribers. Thanks to all my regular subscribers. I love all of you a bunch, and I thank you for everything that you do for me. Watching my videos, sharing my videos, donations that you send me through PayPal. I appreciate it so, so very much. No matter what form it is, just watching my videos, I thank you for it. If you haven't subscribed and you like to keep up with what's going on with the weather, please do so. Click my subscribe button, click that bell, and check off all to make sure you get all the latest weather videos that I put out. Now, here we go down at the tropics. Let's move this up just a little bit if we can right quick. See if we can get it all in here. Here we go. We've been watching this disturbance number one, okay? Right at the moment, I think it may turn into Josephine. We're going to have to wait and see. Even if it does, I don't think it's going to last. So let's see what the National Hurricane Center is going to say. Showers and thunderstorms associated with this tropical wave and broad area of low pressure. It's about 600 miles west-southwest of the Cabo Verde Islands, has changed little in organization since yesterday. Now, the environmental conditions are expected to be somewhat conducive for development to occur, and a tropical depression could form during the next day or two. While this disturbance moves generally westward to the west-northwestward area at around 10 to 15 miles per hour. It's going to slow up a little bit across the tropical Atlantic. Now, conditions are forecast to become less conducive for development by the end of the week. But for the next 2 days, the next 5 days, it has a 60% chance of forming. So that's a good chance it could become Josephine. Now, it's headed over this way. Now, everyone on the island area right in here, maybe Puerto Rico, Dominican Republic, I still think at this time it's not going to be nothing. It may become something, but it looks to me like it's probably going to dissipate by the time it gets to you guys, but you guys will get maybe a gust of wind and some rain out of it. We'll keep our eyes on it, and everybody needs to stay abreast of this up and down the Gulf Coast states and up and down the eastern seaboard. Okay, out in the Atlantic right now, you can see the island chain right here. Here's the Dominican Republic, Puerto Rico. This is the system that we are watching right in here. You can see what it looks like. There's no formation. It is a wave, and it looks like it's elongated. It's in some good water zone, but you see this color here. That's going to be dust. Let's go just to visible instead of infrared. I think this dust, Saharan dust, is going to get in this. It's already looking like it's starting to mix in a little with it. If it pushes on out, if it gets over here, though, this is where it has a chance of forming, right in this area. Not much dust, not much wind shear going on. It could form. That is why it's so important for everyone to keep abreast. If the dust don't get it, and the shear wind don't get it, then we're going to have a problem. But hopefully that's not going to happen. I think once it moves over a little closer and it does get out of the dust some, I think there will be some wind shear that may make this break down. And we can already see some of the Saharan dust is already mixing in. It may just poop out right along in here before it even gets close to you. Either way, everybody up and down the eastern seaboard, the Gulf Coast states, and all of the island areas need to pay attention until we get rid of this system. As we look over in the eastern Pacific this morning, this is disturbance number one. It's going to be popping up real soon. It's just an area of low pressure, and it should form over the western portion of the eastern Pacific basin in just a couple of days, and the environmental conditions are forecast to be conducive for some gradual development, and a tropical depression could form late this week while it moves slowly westward toward the central Pacific basin. It has zero chance in 2 days. In 5 days, it's got a 60% chance. Now, here we have disturbance number two. It's another area of low pressure. It's forecast to develop well offshore the southwestern coast of Mexico around the middle of the week. Now, gradual development is possible thereafter, and it could become a tropical depression also by late this week while it moves west-northwestward. 0% in 2 days, 60% in 5 days. And of course, here we have Alida. It's a tropical storm Alida. Now, her winds are 65 miles per hour. Her pressure is 995 millibars. If you're tracking 18.3 north, 108.8 west, it is moving west-northwest around 15 miles per hour. I think Alida may become a hurricane. We're going to have to wait and see. But I think it could become a hurricane at this point. Now, as we wrap it up and take a look at what might be happening the next 2 to 3 days on the NAM map, courtesy of Tropical Tidbit, before I turn it on, man, oh man, have you guys been having very, very strong lightning lately? I mean, you know, the electricity kind, where the orange goes through the streak of lightning. I'm not talking about heat lightning. It seems to be forming more with thunderstorms as they happen these days. So I've seen it at my house for hours on end. If you see this, please be safe. We're going to turn on the NAM map now, courtesy of Tropical Tidbits. And we have a front over the upper Midwest. It's going to slowly move toward the northeast and the Ohio Valley, also sagging toward the southern plains. Now, the moisture will pool along the boundary, and that's going to aid in the development of showers and thunderstorms. And we do have that risk of severe thunderstorms over the central plains, middle Mississippi Valley, and western Ohio Valley. Now, the main hazards with these storms are going to be this dangerous lightning to severe thunderstorm, wind, gust, and hail. And it's looking like we also have excessive rainfall over parts of the middle Mississippi Valley and the western Ohio Valley. Now, with the rich summertime moisture in place, clusters of these thunderstorms will produce locally very heavy rainfall over a very short period of time. And of course, that could result in some scattered flash flooding today and tonight. In addition, tropical moisture over the southeast states along with the central Gulf Coast, that's going to give rise to the afternoon showers and thunderstorms today and Tuesday. And Tuesday, the moisture should surge back northward over the central northern plains, supporting additional rain and thunderstorms in the area. And like I've told you, expect another hot afternoon for much of the eastern, southern, and western U.S. today. The combination of temperatures in the 90s and high humidity has prompted heat advisories for parts of the central and eastern U.S., and it's looking like temperatures are going to continue above normal in the southeast, where lately monsoon thunderstorms have been usually active. We do have that fire weather conditions that remain elevated over the parts of the southwest Great Basin through Wednesday, as I have showed you. And that's a complete check of your weather today. Have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day. And may each and every one of you have much peace, love, and kindness in your life today. Thank you so much for watching.